Here we're looking at a quick deck tech before we get into our MTG quick hits for Azorius Lotus Field Control. As a friendly reminder, if you do like Pioneer content, please consider subscribing to the channel, giving us a thumbs up, leaving a constructive comment down below. So, Lotus Field combo. This is a pseudo ramp deck, pseudo control deck based around Lotus Field combo. Generally, in game one, you aggressively mulligan towards Lotus Field. There are another variant of this deck that runs some number of copies of Sylvan Scrying and a little bit green heavier mana base to have more redundant copies of the card. However, we are choosing to play the more traditional version of Azorius Lotus Field Control. Lotus Field, in order to keep the drawback from happening, you have access to the cards Strict Proctor and, to a lesser extent, Discontinuity. Basically, your ideal setup is land on one, land on two, cast Strict Proctor, play Lotus Field, trigger happens even if your opponent kills Strict Proctor, you're suddenly untapping with 5, possibly 6 mana on turn 4, then you try to play one of your broken, you know, Teferi, Hero Dominaria in order to really get ahead in that regard. Beyond that, you have a bunch of big sweepers, Doomscar you can foretell on 2, cast on 3 against the faster aggro decks. Farewell cleans up against almost anything that isn't instant speed, so very good against your mid-range and over-the-top decks like Mono Green, Enigmatic Fires, etc., with the exception of it doesn't hit Planeswalkers. And then you play a little bit of early disruption in the form of things like Sensor and Jawari Disruption, and then you try to play a bunch of things that take advantage of 4 mana. Now, this version is playing the Wandering Emperor, Memory Deluge, and Rewind as ways to take advantage of that 4 mana spot that you can untap with Teferi on turn 3 or 4, or turn 4, sorry. Beyond that, some versions have played things like Cellular Wreckage in order to better leverage that spot. This version does not do that. Another card that you see in some of these versions in the place of some of the counter spells is something like Impulse as a way to dig for your Lotus Fields. So it really just comes down to, do you want to play a longer control game? Do you want to play a little bit more dig and Impulse? Or do you want to play the kind of guaranteed turn to Sylvan Scrying? Each version has their slight tweaks to them, but they're all trying to do effectively the same thing. Get to Lotus Thrill on Fury, untap with it on 4, somewhere down the line, copy it with the Thespian Stage, and muster like Lotus Field combo when it transitions into the Zakama control deck. The deck really tries to leverage the ridiculous amounts of mana that it can do and just play broken control things, kind of like almost like a blue Tron-esque deck. Beyond that, you have things like Dream Trawler. Some versions run Shark Typhoon to help close out the game. And then you have just a bunch of big spells. Discontinuity is effectively Time Walk, especially once you get the mana rolling. This is much better when obviously you're trying to get ahead with your Teferi ticking up towards Ultimate, which can be one of your major win cons. And then you get to play a bunch of utility lands, one of Castle Ardenvale, one of Castle Vantress, one of Hall of the Storm Giants, in addition to your Lotus Fields. When you're running 2, 3, 4 Thespian Stages, this allows you to kind of double up on your win cons, or potentially, you know, copy the land and use it without, you know, something like Blast Zone, without actually, you know, running into problems with running out of your only copy of it. As you'll see in this video, sometimes that land base does come up, so don't ever discount it. Sideboard, you can see a myriad of different things. Sometimes you'll see more copies of Aether Gust, sometimes you'll see different sweepers. A lot of times it's just alternate win cons, especially against control decks, and then you'll see, you know, something to help against the combo decks. Aether Gust primarily here for mono green, can also come in some other spots, but mainly here for mono green. Narset's Reversal, great against extraction effects, Thought Seizes, Thoughts Distortions, Storm of the Festivals, etc. I wasn't impressed with it in Explore when I was playing this deck, but it is a little bit better in Pioneer because you have the full-blown Lotus Field combo deck. And then Thought Distortion for control and combo, much like Lotus Field, Blue-White Control, the mirror match. Dovin's Veto when you're playing against a bunch of, you know, non-creature spells, mainly Lotus Field combo, can bring it in against the control mirror, etc. Dream Trawler, alternate win con, or additional win con, especially against other creature decks. Same thing with Dragonlord Dromoka. Dragonlord Dromoka is especially good against spirits, them not being having a difficult time to remove it, and the fact that it can't be countered and keeps them from playing on spells on your turn. Niv-Mizzet is kind of a similar effect to Dromoka, but a little bit better in terms of pinging down boards and stuff. But it is also uncounterable and can be annoying to deal with. And then Tamiyo, Collector of Tales, is kind of an attrition-based card. If it happens to come down, it makes discard spells extremely terrible and helps to rebuy key cards that you're looking for, as well as dig for them, like your Lotus Field combo. So that is Azorius Lotus Field combo. Be prepared to strap in. We only played one match, but it is a doozy. So enjoy. Hope to see you for our next video. All right, we're here with our quick hits with Azorius Lotus Field control. Hold it too clunky of a hand, I think. This hand's fine, albeit not thrilled about that back. Done. Alright. And pass. Always pretty much want to mulligan the Lotus Field if at all possible. Turn one Thoughtseize, goodbye Teferi. Find this continuity or a okay pass. One might say I'm pessimistic about this game. Pass. Well, do they counter this? Okay. That was basically the perfect time to draw that. Yep, sorry, Thought Thief. Okay, main deck Unmoored Ego. Ain't that some bullsh? It's like, where did the combo deck hurt you? Response, I think we have to deluge here before they get deluge discontinuity before they can whatchamacallit. 6, 10 mana. Doomscar. Sure, one has only one card in hand, so good chance we'll be able to wrath the board one way or another next turn. This for 5. Okay, so only one card in hand. Alright, Wonder Emperor. Opponent must really want a thought save the Wonder Emperor. Pass. So, memory damage. Sure, take that hit and like it. Oops. So good game to our opponent. opponent. So we're up against Faye. We just bring out a bunch of alternative win cons, particularly the uncounterable kind. So that's reversal, gets a little bit more appealing against something like Thoughtseize. Cards am I not interested in? Finale, Undo Inversion, one of copy of Teferi, Turfluffle. Of course, that's a reversal. Shave a Dream Trawler. Aethercrest does nothing. Dovin Vetoes, whatever. Thought Distortion's not as good against them. Maybe a copy of Rewind because it's a little clunky. Once again, you are in game one, first and foremost, a Tron-esque style deck. You need to assemble the mana, then the big powerful stuff. Game 2 and Game 3 can become a little bit more like blue-white traditional control if the situation calls for it. Historically, when I've played this deck, I've preferred the Sylvan Scrying version, but I really only have seen one person running it. You take a look at the playlist that we'll have up that includes some of the stuff from our Arena channel. Can't keep this one. Bit of a risky hand, not gonna lie there. Keep that and this continuity, and hope we draw a land, right? Land or two. Turn one, Thugseize. Nope. All right. All right, opponent does Thieves Guild Enforcer, which is annoying. Okay, sure. Opponent's got the nice aggressive start they're looking for. Really looking to hold up Sensor in case they have, whatchamacallit again, Extraction effect they played last game. I don't think we're going to have the time to set up, so it's possible I should have held the discontinuity instead of the Niv-Mizzet. So they had any more pressure to the board, or just Dedge. Alright, and move on. Too far behind this game. Don't want our opponent to see all the cards we brought in against them, so something to play first. Can I risk this hand? Sure. Doesn't have a Lotus Field, but we have enough early disruption that I think I'm fine keeping it. being smart. They're main phasing their stuff. Spell while you can. Sure, consider resolves. It's got quite the interesting hand. So we're trying to play around the end. With a lot of extraction effects, I'll get in that much. Take a hit for 4. Thank you. They have a flash threat. We're just in a world of trouble here. Nope. Oh, for Lord Almighty's sake. Sure. At least they're consistent with what they name. Probably commit Sore into the board. Interesting. They would try to use the end here. How is the N word exactly? guess they get to do this and attack with, or yeah, that's fine. Play shouldered. Green. Sure. Clint doesn't have much in the way of actual counter magic. So it's reversal. They have access to Brazen Borrower, which is admittedly annoying. Why would you bounce that one? Okay. One more to go, sure. What a slog of a game. See if they have Test of Talents or something similar. Cast this one first in case they have Test of Talents. That way they won't be able to exile it from. Mm-hmm. Alright, and good grief. Discontinuity. Lotus Field, I guess. Should have just got this continuity'd. Thoughtsies, sure. With way too many extraction effects in their deck. Sure. Like, Lutri would literally be like their worst. Which means there go literally all of our win cons. Let's attack everything at Sorin. Please, by all means, activate your Herald of this Hall of the Storm Giants. So all creatures. Activate. Get a 6. Fine with that. Deluge. Do we even have a farewell left to draw to? I think we have one left. Okay, Ganju and Memory Deluge. Cast Memory Deluge. Farewell and Blossom, just cuz. So all creatures. Truly insane game. Sure. And pass. Should have cast Strict Broker. game. What an insane game. Hmm.